Welcome in, everyone, to another edition of Yes, We're Here. And we have got an extraordinary guest, the incomparable Allie Love. Allie, I was looking at all the titles that you hold, host, model, speaker, Peloton instructor, motivation in a nutshell is what it is, a businesswoman, and a beautiful human being. And so I want to start off by saying, and I know so many of our viewers follow you on social media and kind of had an insight to what your life has been like during this uncertain time, but tell us how you're doing, how you've been dealing with everything, and just your attitude that you bring every single morning.
Oh, well, first off, thanks for having me, Sarah. So good to see you all bright and shiny and looking great. I am doing well. I think in light of the circumstances, I am doing the best that I can, and that's all we can ever hope for. But I have really tried my best to make the most out of staying inside and kind of sticking to my normal routine, but also introducing some new quarantine routines by continuing to write things down, stay connected via social, doing FaceTimes, working out, turning my apartment into my own gym, my office, really kind of going, straddling the fence of like my home being so many things. So for the most part, I'm doing well. Thank you for asking.
No, that's the important thing. I think we've been able to talk to so many families, so many friends, so many others through social media. And that's such an important question of just how are you doing? Because this is impacting, it's impacting everyone, but it's impacting everyone in such different ways. Is there something throughout this, and I know you have such a great self-awareness and just always checking in with yourself, but is there something that you've learned about yourself maybe throughout the course of these last couple of weeks that you didn't necessarily know or realize?
I think that what I really realized about myself is that while I feel like I am a creative being and I'm always up to creating and innovating with ideas, I think that this situation has really put me in a position to definitely create nothing, I mean, something out of nothing. So what I mean by that is like waking up, trying to stick to my daily routine as much as possible has been challenging because obviously I'm inside. And so with that, it puts me in a position to say, you know what, let me do all the things that I said I never had the time to do, but always wanted to do. And so I kick off each day, most of my days, except for my birthday, because I celebrated, but most of my days I start off by going on Instagram Live. And now while that doesn't seem like a big deal, for many of us, even if we are in front of the camera, Sarah, you understand that that's an additional layer of getting in front of the camera in your normal daily routine. So that's something that I'd always put off. But what I've been doing is every day, I start my mornings, I make my hot water, lemon and honey. I sit in my window seal, put my phone and go on live. And I ask everyone who hops on my live to say their name and where they're from so that you see that you're not alone. And I call it my daily dose of love. And I give everyone a call to action and you can take it or leave it. And call to actions could be, you know, text someone, I'm sending you love and light. Work on 5-minute core, download the 90 day. We have 90 days free at Peloton. Download the app if you don't have anything in terms of getting a workout in today. But making sure that we're taking care of our physical and our mental and spiritual. And so my call to actions are usually binary of like, here, do this workout or do at least this by moving your body today. And then in terms of mind, write down how you're feeling. Cut yourself a break. I started asking people to cut other people a break. Maybe start off with a joke, research a joke. So really, really fun call to actions that allow all of my community, including myself, to ground us when we feel that anxiety creep up. Or when you're sitting there, you're like, am I supposed to be doing something? I'm working from home and I feel the most unproductive. So it definitely put me in a position, like I said, to create something out of nothing, to explore those projects that I'd always push to the side and to sit down and say, you know, what do I want to do? To think about who am I in this time? Who do I want to be? Who do people see me as? And so really getting back to the basics and the fundamentals and allowing myself time to just be me and not have all the answers.
Yeah, I think why we all love you for a million reasons, but what resonates is the fact that you have always been your authentic, genuine self. And I think so many of the things that we grasp on when people are facing challenges or obstacles throughout this time, because we all are in this, is the understanding that people go through different things each and every day. And so, so many individuals know you as a Peloton instructor. And it ranges from, which is what I would love to appreciate, those, you know, just starting to work out, professional athletes, those in the music industry, whoever, it ranges across the board. But what I always grasp and hold on to is the fact that I think what people really feel most from you is, of course, the physical workout, but the mental and the emotional stability that you provide. And in doing that, when I call you a businesswoman, you're the founder of Love Squad. And if others don't know about that, tell us a little bit about how you started that, why you started that, and why it's so important to you.
Well, in everything that I do, I think it's really important to have a neuromuscular connection. So your body's there, but also your mind and your spirit's present. And so yes, when I'm teaching on Peloton, Sundays with Love, it's definitely spiritually grounded. It's a celebration of life wrapped into a thought-provoking ride, and we focus on a virtue. And that ranges, yes, like you said, I'll do Sundays with Love, and then I'll have a pop ride where it's a party and we're gonna get lit. Everybody needs something at different times, and we're so multifaceted. And that's exactly how I approached Love Squad. Love Squad came out of a sheer need for myself as a young woman trying to figure it out in the city, where I needed resources that were accessible but also free, because I didn't have the means to go to all these events and network. And so I created Love Squad as a space where, at a low to no cost, you invite people that are, we're very inclusive, very diverse. When you walk in a Love Squad event, you feel invited. You also feel like you belong. So I created, and we hold space where we come out and we exchange information. So from branding materials, the things you didn't know about branding, branding 101, to building a business, to understanding how to hit your top line revenue, to understanding what does it feel like to work with your employees, to be great managers, or just when you have that side hustle and when do you turn it into a full-time business. Having those conversations, because I feel like when women in particular, just all people, feel pretty good about their career and their career trajectory, it puts them in a position to make better choices and decisions around their lives, around their love lives, around their kids. It just really fills you up. And so I think Love Squad, it was just like, it was birthed out of that, and it's evolved ever since. And we, of course, scalability is important in terms of what do you do in the times like this. We did our first virtual event yesterday. We're like, you know what, let's try it. We've never done this before. Maybe this is something we should explore. And it went well, we were all learning how to work the new Zooms and the new this and that. And so having people on their time come in and say, you know what, ask questions in the chat. I answer all those questions, do a presentation, a split screen. It was really cool to see that, because one, people are watching Love Squad in real time as a small business evolve and scale. But also, most importantly, we're in a position where we want to continue to encourage, inspire, and uplift anyone that hears, that comes across our events, anyone that comes across our Instagram, that goes to our website, that gets our newsletter, and they feel connected. It's a space for everyone. So that's why it was created, and that's how we're kind of going along in these times. And I encourage anyone, if you have a business, an idea, or you're just feeling like anxious about the unknown or anticipatory grief, you're like, I am sad and I don't even know why, because I'm feeling anxious that something bad is going to happen. Really take the time to explore the things that you want, you always wanted to do. It doesn't have to be perfect. We always talk about that. It's not about being perfect. Whether you're on Peloton, you come to a Love Squad event, or you come to a Brooklyn Nets game, there's no perfect fan. As long as you show up and you bring your whole self and you're willing to receive the entertainment, the game, the motivational speaking, the road ahead, then that's all we, you know, ask for.
Well, you've touched on two things that I want to get to, because I first met you when we both came to Brooklyn in different roles with the Brooklyn Nets, and you are the in-arena host for Barclays Center for the Brooklyn Nets. We're going to get to that in a second. But what I have just appreciated and found to be such an extraordinarily inspiring thing is watching you grow and watching you grow your business and watching you continue to inspire and lift up others. And so much of that comes from what you do with Love Squad. But I mean, girl, you've been doing a variety of different things, taking over the world. But with that, in doing a TED talk, your mantra has been bossing up and bossing up. Explain that to us. And I know you've probably touched on that some, and just where that comes from.
Well, I do want to give you a huge shout out. Kudos to you, Sarah Kustok, because when I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do, you were someone, and we both work at the Brooklyn Nets, and obviously you were way more well-known than I am. No one knew who I was. I just started hosting, had no idea. And I asked you to like meet up with me and give me advice, and you did. And you were just, it wasn't even, it didn't even take you a second. You were like, of course. And ever since we've been, I've again had the privilege to be friends with you and watch your career grow. But I do want to say a big thank you and use this platform now to say thank you, because you've not only inspired me, but you've also helped me and encouraged me in many times. So thank you so much.
Right back at you, girl. Thank you. But you were on your grind. You had a vision. You had the hustle. Because if anyone sees you and watches you, they know that you are pouring your whole self into what it is you do. But what is bossing up?
Yeah, so being a boss, and we hear that all the time in rap songs. You hear it in, you know, little kids saying it. You hear it obviously as a formal title at work. And what I wanted to do, and this is normally what I like to do, is disrupt in a very understanding way, rebel with a cause kind of thing. The concept of boss no longer having a negative connotation or belonging to one type of pronoun, one pronoun. It can be for anyone. I'm not a boss lady. I'm not a boss girl. I'm not a lady boss. I'm just a boss. And the reason that was a big deal for me is because I feel like bosses set the standard and establish the tone. And that means that no matter what your job title is, where you live, what team you root for, what your PR is on Peloton, or how many Love Squad events you've come to, you're still a boss. Being a boss means any room you walk into, you can establish your standard. You know the rules, but you're able to innovate, be creative, and decide to bring your whole self there. And then, of course, when I say set the tone, you have the ability to change people's attitude. You have the ability to affect people's emotions. You can be the positive light in the room. You can also be the negative light. Whatever you decide to be, and most times I encourage you to be the positive, the light at the end of the tunnel, to be the person that comes in and be not only innovative, but most importantly, encouraging, you get to be that. And I think that that's what it means to be a boss. And that's where I decided to take that title and own it. And when you boss up, you're like, despite of my circumstances, despite of being caught in my apartment or my home for, you know, many days, I'm going to boss up. I'm not going to allow this to affect me. I'm going to feel all the feels, but I'm not going to allow it to basically suffocate me or push me down so much where I can't do anything. I'm going to turn this around. I'm going to be innovative. I'm going to be creative. I'm going to come with some ideas, some things that are out of the box that may not make sense. I'm going to try them, and I'm going to set the tone in my house or my FaceTime or whoever I talk to. I just always starting with something positive, starting with a joke, lightening things up, saying that, you know, while things are this way now, it will be better later. Always identifying that joy will come again. So I really took that word to heart, and I wanted to redefine what it meant in terms of its definition in the dictionary, but also how we use it in everyday language. And just say, you know what, everyone's a boss if you decide to be. So set this tone, establish a standard, because you have that ability to do so. And I learned that because I think you don't get anything by just it coming to you. You got to work hard for everything. And that's what bosses do. You work hard. It's not easy setting the standard. It's not easy coming into a room and setting a tone that can be positive. It takes time.
You are a boss in every area. And I want to ask you one more thing. I've been keeping you way too long. So I mentioned, and so many of us know, the way in which, when I talk about players on the floor and we're describing them, we talk about players that have gravity. And girl, you have got gravity because you own whatever arena, whatever space you are in, and do so in Barclays Center as the in-arena host. You have hosted NBA All-Star games. You've hosted NBA drafts. You've done it all. The list goes on. But the Brooklyn Nets fans and Barclays Center, they want to call you their own. So the aura that you bring, the light that you bring to the arena, what message do you want to give them in just what you miss, what you love and appreciate most about that role that you have?
Well, as we all know, being in that arena is truly special. And it's not special because of how beautiful it is. It's special for the people that come in that building. And it's from anywhere from our ushers to our players, to our organization, to our fans. And if there's one message that I could send, is that one, Brooklyn is always rooted in the heart and we always go hard. But keep in mind that Brooklyn is a family and a community. And we have definitely been hit with some hard times in the past, and it will always be that. But Brooklyn always rallies back. We have always been the underdog. We've always been looked at such, but we've always rallied back. We've always been a surprise factor. And that is especially in times like now. If you are a Brooklyn Nets fan, if you live in Brooklyn and you're part of the Brooklyn family, or you're looking for a family, we are here. And just know, while things may seem grim, it may seem down right now, Brooklyn is known for one thing, and that's always fighting its way back to the top. And we'll continue to do so.
Well, Allie, love you. Inspire us all. You have a bravery, a fierceness, a resiliency, a shining light that we all appreciate so much. So keep changing the world. Thank you for joining us on Yes, We're Here.